this hearing a few months ago, and there was a problem that was identified by someone that was opposed to the bid, and with the public hearing, and the city attorney advised that the process needed to start over. The balloting was redone, and today is a public hearing for the bid. After the conclusion of this public hearing, the city clerk will tabulate the votes, and the results will be announced tomorrow. It's tomorrow we actually vote to certify those results. So today is the public hearing. Every person who is here today and wants to speak, according to the law, has allowed an opportunity to speak, and will be afforded that opportunity today. And I've already asked the council president, because we have a new voting system today, after everybody who's called has spoken, I just want to see if there's anybody who somehow didn't get called up to make sure that they spoke so that we don't have any issues. With that, Mr. President, I suggest we begin the public hearing.
All right, so I want to let everybody know, everybody can come up for a minute each, and we've got 45 cards so far. So we're at a minimum of 45. Often it takes a little longer to get through that. So I want to let you know as well. If you find that it's up to you, we are going to ask everybody that has still allowed an opportunity to speak to come out and speak. If you hear that perhaps there are people being repetitive with the same information, feel free to just say you agree or disagree, whatever you like. You still have your minute. Just start it off, and if you start coming up, Jed Hawker, followed by Margaret Boy, David Ewing, Becky Dennison, Linda Lux. You all can start coming up. And then state your name at your own page as well, if you're really happy you are. Thank you so much.
Thank you for your service. My name is Jed Hawker. I live in Venice. Understanding that many or most of you inherited our homelessness crisis, I ask that you all oppose this bid. It can't do homeless outreach, it can't give citations, it can't move belongings, it can't cite illegal short-term rentals for LS Act violations. Based on facts, it will deny representation, it will drive out existing businesses and residents, it will deepen the homelessness crisis, which has been made worse by some of the very illegal businesses behind the bid. It will make the city complicit in denying due process. It will not protect the city from existing service requirements. Venice is exploring secession. Regardless of results of that process, they will definitely loudly publicize perceived failures by this council. Maintaining peace is your first duty. Approving this bid is an invitation to unrest in a community that is desperate to breathe freely. Please oppose this new undue burden.
Hello, I'm Margaret Malloy. This bid requires 12 votes. I'd like to know where the other council people are. This is a very important issue. Hello, council members, are you present at this stage?
Yeah, we also have speakers, believe it or not, in the restroom and in the back.
To the all side, the periphery, and the other conversations.
They're everywhere.
We would like our due process. We were denied it on many occasions already. We have an email from Debbie Dunham Harris requesting that the issue initially be heard in council, in committee, because there was such interest. Hello, this is election day. This is the rehearing of the suppression of our due process, which caused the first vote to be rescinded. It's a public park. Judge Dean Pregerson said that public parks are the zenith of free speech. You cannot put a business improvement district in a public park. And the majority of city owned properties in that public park.
I'm going to also ask everybody, since we don't get kisses and boos and applause, to you want to get through all the speakers, so if you can please keep your silence when you go to these here. Thank you very much.
Good morning, my name is Becky Dennison. I represent community housing, and we strongly oppose the business improvement district. I think it's really ironic that we're here on election day where we stand on the shoulders of people who fought for one person, one vote, and the right of everyone to vote, that you are now overseeing a vote that only is allowed for non-residential property owners in a very specific area, even though we will all be impacted by the bid. Venice Community Housing is one of those property owning voters, all operate residential property in property that's been approved residential use since 1995 and should not be included in a bid. $10,000 a year for an affordable housing property that will not benefit from any of the marketing, any of the property increases, and that's supposedly what we're paying for. The city also improperly included a lot of their properties, and I just have to say that the longstanding violations by BIF against homeless and low-income people in a neighborhood impacted by homelessness is not appropriate, and if you do approve this bid, which I think you should not, you have to address and direct what security can and cannot do in public space for people. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Ken, if we could keep it locked down and thank you. So excuse me for 1 minute, Matt. We've already informed you, Mr. Herman, the animal sounds. We just meet again and waiting for getting stuck animal sound making sounds. As funny as you think that is, these speakers have been sitting here all day waiting to speak. You've disrupted this meeting one too many times. Mr. Corian asked earlier as well, you need to keep it down. We're not gonna ask you to leave the rest of the meeting. Thank you very much for being here. Goodbye. Excuse me, 1 minute.
It's a public parking area. Leave it alone for people who need parking. I object. Sustained. Overruled.
We're going to ask you to stay out of the water, so keep going.
Take it to the back, Bing Ear.
Good place, loser. Good place, loser. Don't forget. First Amendment.
Thank you very much.
Fourth Amendment.
Good day, council members. My name is Linda Lux. I moved to Venice in 1970. I was president of Venice Neighborhood Council, president of the Board of Neighborhood Commissioners. I currently work for Venice Community Housing. I'm speaking though as a former resident and who raised some kids right there adjacent to the boardwalk. Venice is not a commercial district. It's 99% residential with a strip of commercial on Oceanfront Walk and on Rose. The residents have had no say in this and are going to be the most impacted. Much as I support Council Member Barnes' initiatives on homelessness, this is bullshit. This is not right for Venice. This is completely wrong, and this is not like any other bid that you voted for. This is a residential area with a strip of commercial. You need to think about it. It's going to result in lawsuits. It's going to result in rent-to-cops hurting people. And we have Snapchat security crawling all over the beach area. Google security, you don't need to be a war zone. If you have enough LAPD and Google and Snapchat, you really need to think about this.
Thank you very much. So again, David Ewing, don't fight. And you can just form a line so we can go through them. If you're not up there, we're going to go to the next name, because I've already called you. We're not going to wait every time for each speaker. That's why we're calling several at a time. Marie Kennedy, Mary Kennedy, Sylvia Roth, and Mark Lippman, those are the next speakers. So whoever's up there, in whatever order.
My name is Bill Kluckey, I'm the director of Power. We exposed the bid today, of all days, highlights the contradiction of exposed by the bid. Our national election, in the same way they did vote Donald Trump and his rich friends could put him in the White House without a single speech, ad, or sign. Proponents will say that it only impacts business owners, so they only they have a voice. This is patently untrue. The bid allows almost $2.5 million in public money over 5 years, just blocks away the Vera Data Center, faces chronic threats of shutdown, privatization, and service cuts because of the lack of funds. The richest tech companies, also right down the street, get a massive tax break. We don't need a bid to pay for services. We need corporations to pay their fair share. The bid is undemocratic. It is taxation without representation. No on the Venice bid.
My name is Marie Kennedy. I'm a Venice homeowner and I'm chair of the Venice Community Housing Board. If you approve this bid, you're turning over the governance of public space to private profit-making. As a professor of urban planning, I find this deeply disturbing. The Venice Boardwalk has a particularly well-used and important public space. It's long been one of the few truly racial, multiracial, recreational, and tourist spaces in LA. As the area gentrifies, and it will inevitably become less welcoming to people of all races and all classes, and instead will be yet another enclave of the white and the wealthy community. I urge you to turn this down. And I, like the former speaker, do definitely support Council Bond's policies around homelessness, and I don't understand his support of this bill.
Thank you. Next speaker, please.
Hi, my name is Sylvia Roth. I'm a longtime Venice resident, and I'm here today to ask you to vote against the proposed bid. I do support Mike Bonin for all the great work he's done around homelessness, but I do not understand his support for the bid. To me, the bid is another thinly veiled attempt by speculators at cleaning up, gentrifying, and privatizing our boardwalk. I've lived in Venice for over 40 years and have never been robbed or accosted, unlike my parents who lived in Beverly Hills and were robbed at gunpoint twice. Over 70% of the bid budget is for private security and cleanup. How do you think that will affect the unhoused? If Google and Snapchat were not given an 80% tax break, the city might have the funds to provide needed public services, including opening a bathroom and security, which is allegedly needed. The bid process has been an undemocratic mess. Many attempts have been made to meet with the bid consultants with no response.
Thank you. Next. Thank you.
Hello, Mark Lippin here. Politicians often seem perplexed when their constituents say that they don't trust you, that there's corruption and collusion behind the scenes that go to benefit your wealthy donors. Well, this is exactly why. When you're pushing forward something that is a clear violation of the Coastal Act, number one, that circumvents the democratic process where only the wealthy property owners get to vote on privatizing our public spaces. While this vote, I'm told, one district won't, all the districts will vote for it only because when your wealthy contributors come to you and want to put something in, if you don't vote for this one, then the other constable might not vote for you. This is collusion and corruption at the worst. These business improvement districts are how your campaign contributors get rich. You all know it, we all know it. And why you're doing this is called greed and corruption. That's what this is all about.
Again,
Mark,
please, if we're going to get all the speakers and we want to actually go through the time, keep the applause down for any loser and any things. Be respectful to the one who came out. Please sir, come on up. Next speaker, please. Okay. So again, we go through the next one. David Ewing. Is David here?
He's not.
Okay, let's take him off. General Dawkins. Jefferson Elliott. Followed by Steve. General Hawkins, no? Take them off. Jefferson Elliott.
Hello. Thank you. My name is Jefferson Elliott. I'm a homeowner in Venice. And I'm one of the people whose property is zoned both commercial and residential, but both I and my neighbors have only residential. It seems very unfair just for part of this bid. There should be exempt, there should be a little bit more. It should be just for commercial. Thank you.
Can I get your name again, sir? I'm sorry, please.
Okay.
What your name again?
Jefferson Elliott.
Great, thank you very much. Chris? Collier? Chris? Not here? Okay. Steve Piemont? Followed by Jay Goodfather? Followed by Sam McCullough? Jack.
Good morning, council members. I'm Steve Heeman with Sidewalk Land Trust. We own 2.5 blocks of property on the Venice Boardwalk, including the Sidewalk Cafe and Small World Books, which we have owned and operated for 40 years. We support the formation of the Venice Beach Business Improvement District. The city does not have adequate resources, so we want to join our neighbors and pay our fair share by forming a bid. We think a cleaner and safer Venice will be better for everyone, residents, both housed and homeless, merchants, and visitors. As longtime community members who love Venice, we look forward to working with the new Venice Beach bid and the larger community to address issues in the district in a manner that all Venice stakeholders can support and be proud of and that celebrates the unique, eclectic, and diverse character of Venice. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Next speaker, please.
Hello, my name is Jay Goodfader. My family owns the Sidewalk Cafe Restaurant, Small World Books. I grew up and still live in Venice 40 years now. Cafe's 40 years old this year. I support the bid, and my whole family does, the people at the bookstore too. I love it, you know, this is a perfect world and the city can pay to clean everything every day, what it means when we have people and kids playing in a public health hazard and there's not enough to clean up, the bathrooms are a mess and everything else is a mess. So a bid, you know, we've been putting forth money to clean the area as much as we can, but without everyone's help we can't do it, so I support the bid and I'm happy to pay more than our share to make this happen.
Thank you, council members. Chris Quare with the LA Times Union, and just wanted to say that we're standing in solidarity with the residents of Venice and opposing the bid, and the community members, the long-term community members that will be displaced inevitably by the bid.
Thank you.
Good morning, council. My name is Sam Lapata. I'm a resident of Venice. I also work in Venice. I wanted to show my support for the bid. Venice needs this tremendously. We have huge problems with drug use, vandalism, cleanup, and it would be great to see us a little bit cleaner. I want to support the bid, and thank you for your time.
Thank you.
Good morning. My name is Jack Hoffman. I am a 30-year resident property owner in Venice. One of my properties is residentially zoned on commercial land, and I'm happy to support the bid. It's the broadest collective effort I've ever seen attempted in Venice to actually apply resources in the direction of cleaning and making our streets safer. We're in dire need of the areas way too specific in terms of its problems to be dealt with in a general way, and this allows us to be very precise about what we plan to do with the resources we want. We appreciate it. Thank you for your support very much.
Thank you very much. Hey, Mark, Zakal, Michael Morris, James, you're in it. Katie Downey.
Good afternoon, honorable city council members. My name is Mark Sokol, and my family is in the Hotel Irwin, and we've been in Venice since the 1950s. I also participated in my fund in Venice Forward Group to end homelessness in Venice, and I want to let you know that we strongly support the bid. We're in the bid zone, and the bid will make Venice cleaner and safer. And while I respectfully disagree with my friends on the other side of the aisle on this issue, I do know, and I really hope and believe that we can work together on goals that we share, which is to make Venice safer, cleaner, and homelessness in Venice. Thank you.
And before the next speaker, there's a gentleman that's standing, and while I've called several days, you haven't come up yet. I don't know if I've got your name. Do you have your name in?
It was Aaron and Jennifer Peter.
Okay, then we'll get to it, sir. If I haven't called your name yet, we can try to keep the aisles clear. Please either have a seat, or if you wish to stand, you can, or just stand in the back or on the side. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Michael Morris. I've been in Venice for 23 years. And I'm here to support the bid today because I've spent a lot of time in Venice. I've seen the changes. Long story short, you know, that corner needs bid. Very, very dangerous. As soon as the sun goes down, the predators start hunting the tourists. I've seen robberies night and day. I've seen all kinds of like pure insanity, drug dealing, nonstop violence. And you know, it's the same thing with a visited tourist spot in Los Angeles. I mean, Venice Beach in this one area has become a health hazard. And you know, honestly, it's an embarrassment and a shame. You know, this is part of Los Angeles. It's completely neglected, and it's time to move forward and start taking care of it. It's like the forgotten stepchild that nobody cares about. And you know, it's really a shame that tourists have to come here to be picked up nonstop. I see people breaking their cars, people pulling knives on people. I have a stab wound on my hand.
Thank you. Thank you.
Have a great day.
Thank you very much. Hi, good morning.
My name is James Maris, 30-year resident of Venice. I'm currently a board member on the Venice Neighborhood Council. I'm not speaking for the Neighborhood Council, I'm speaking for myself. I live and work within the bid area. I have a property that will be, actually two properties, that will be paying fees. I've managed the Venice Farmers Market for 29 years, which is every Friday morning. I planted 1,400 trees in the early 90s throughout Venice. All the trees on Venice Boulevard. I think it would be great to have some help cleaning up the community. I know every Friday morning when I go to the farmer's market, the first thing I have to do is have our cleaning person go around and pick up syringes and broken bottles and other trash throughout the city parking lot because the city doesn't seem to manage that. The same thing is true in a lot of the tree wells that are up and down the sidewalks on major visitor thoroughfares. It's a shame that we don't have the money, but I think that this will help. And I'm happy to do my part.
Thank you very much.
Hi, I'm Katie Downing, and I'm a resident of Venice. I live at 45 Market Street, and I'm strongly in favor of the bid, and thank you for your support.
Thank you very much. Okay, next speakers are Paul Abstall, George. This has got to be a typo. So George, I want to get the last name. Paul Abstall. You have two cards, you only have one option. George Francisco, I apologize. It's an A, not a C. Francisco, we got Suzanne Thompson and Andy Lehman.
Hi, I'm Paul Abstall, a 30-year resident of Venice. I own a home just off the boardwalk. I fully support the bid proposal. Bids, influx of money, and new energy is exactly what the oceanfront desperately needs. It will help restore it back to what it was intended to be, a clean, safe, beautiful place for people to enjoy where the laws are enforced. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Morning. My name is George Francisco. I'm a 25-year resident of Venice. I'm currently the vice president of the Venice Neighborhood Council. Pacific Division's Police Advisory Board. I'm also the president of the Venice Chamber of Commerce. Today I'm here as an individual long-term resident and also the president of the Chamber of Commerce to officially support the creation of Venice Beach bid. From some of the things you may hear, you would assume that Venice is teeming with corporations, law firms, accounting firms. If you take away Whole Foods, Google, and Snapchat, our Chamber of Commerce membership is strongly made up of small businesses, over 350, and between 1 and 15 employees. We strongly support a healthier business environment, more activity, and a way to make our streets safer for residents, visitors, and property and business owners alike. We support the bid and appreciate your support too. I also hope that you allow every single last person to speak this time. Thank you all.
Good afternoon, council members. My name is Suzanne Thompson. I'm a 30-year resident of Venice and former president of the Venice Labor Council, founder of the Venice Arts Council, and a member of the Venice Japanese American Memorial Monument Committee. But I'm here today as an individual. And with my work that I've done through the Venice Arts Council, the Endangered Art Fund, I've spent over 10 years trying to find resources. Councilman Bauman and Councilman Rosenthal have been supportive and very appreciative of that. One of the main things that I really am supportive of this bid is to be able to have the restrooms open 24/7. We have a wonderful Venice Beach Poets Monument that's located on the public restrooms and the police and recreation substation on Venice Beach. And we need resources desperately to maintain our public art because art is always at the bottom of the barrel for funding. So please support this and thank you, Councilman Bond, for your support.
Thank you very much. So Andy, followed by David Bush, R.S. Klein, Gene Cunningham, Michael Hamilton.
Okay. My name is Andy Lehman. I'm the owner-operator of Venice Beach Suites and Hotel, which is a 105-year-old hotel at the center of Venice Beach. I've owned this property for over 30 years. one thing I want to reassure an awful lot of people is the last thing I and most of my constituents want is this place to turn into a Santa Monica 13 promenade. We want to keep the funkiness, the bohemian atmosphere. Most of us property owners on the boardwalk know the homeless down there. We try to help them. And this is one opportunity for us property owners to join together and provide additional funding for the homeless. So I'm strongly in favor of the vision. Thank you.
Great, thank you.
Good afternoon, council members. Tara Devine, Vine Strategies, consultant to the Venice Beach bid. I'm going to keep my remarks very brief. I simply want to make sure there are some people here in support today who have elected not to speak to you, but they did take the time to come out today to show their support. I'd like to ask everyone in support to please stand. If you have any questions for me, I'm available. Thank you.
Dave Bush. I've been both a resident housed in Venice Beach, a member for the city, as a diesel mechanic, and also homeless, as I am today. I've also opened up several food lines and been long involved in homeless issues in Venice Beach. There's a pressing need in Venice, but it's not for bid. It's for security guards to guard the toilets. We have over 1,000 homeless people every single night in Venice. And when I was arrested and put on trial for opening up a toilet, in the face of this lack, I was told by the LAPD who tried to get toilets open there that they didn't have the money because you were the city, you couldn't find the money for security guards for toilets in Venice Beach at night. How is it that you can find money and create assessments through a scheme for to guard businesses during the day when you can't find the money to meet a basic fundamental human right for security guards for toilets for homeless people at night? If you're going to have a bid, at least make sure that it guards some toilets for homeless people at night.
No businesses, just residential homes and rentals of parcels that are unlucky enough to be zoned commercial. City services work very well on San Juan Avenue. We have no complaints, except for the fact that our properties were placed into the bid with no notice, no chance to participate in the formative process, and no benefit to our property should the bid be approved. Why was the arbitrary formation of the bid done in secret? Why are parcels with no possible business or commercial use placed in the bid? Why is a commercial building at 248 Westminster Avenue, my next door neighbor, that is a four-story office zone C2, which houses Snapchat, not in the bid? And please reconsider this.
Thank you.
Good afternoon. My name is Michael Hamilton, 57-year resident and property owner in Venice, 702 Hampton Drive. The biggest question I have in regards to this was the gentleman just talked about now. Hampton Drive, there's 10 homes between Vernon and Indiana that are all residents. They are C-zoned, but they've never, in 60 years that they've been there, they've never been any type of business. And now we've been, I'm going to say, gerrymandered into this thing. Want to find out why we had no voice in it. And I do support what you do for homeless people, I do, but to do this for residents, I think is very unfair. And why is that became? There's not any, nothing that I can do with food business. And you're talking about somebody I was talking about Venice Boulevard. I mean, that's just as close to that as I can get. So I want to thank you very much. Please reconsider if nothing else. Take a look at the houses that are there that they have nothing to do with any businesses. We're not going to give this no kind of business to someone who's a resident.
Abigail Dunlap, owned by Walt, Centerfit, Liza, Persky, Kevin, Braxel,
affected by this. We strongly oppose the creation of the event. We strongly support the idea of a community coming together to organize for the rights of all residents, including its houseless ones, and for the cleanup and creation of amenities and access to the communities that everybody needs. But the bid is an anti-democratic way of whose history across the country and our city in terms of its disparate impact on the most vulnerable among us is clear. If the question is resources, there are ways to create resources without adding to the problems by which people can hire people to do neighborhood community cleanup that's democratically accountable to everybody in the district, not to people who are happy to be in the voters and have a right to vote by sake of their operation of the private life.
My name is Kevin Wright. I'm a 20-year resident of Venice, and I've owned an artisan residence building in Venice for over 16 years. Now, this whole bid process has been exclusionary, which I don't really understand. It's been done in secret. We just found out about it a few months ago. And, you know, my repeated attempts to meet with you, Mike, have been denied over and over. You've been good for us, and I can only think that it's because you.
If you could address the council as a whole.
And my family will be affected to the tune of thousands of dollars in order to take care of properties that have owners that I don't know are, you know, too lazy or too incompetent or whatever, can't take care of their own property. And I don't understand the undemocratic vote that we've heard about over and over and over. You know, gerrymandering, the medians in the parking lot was a dirty trick. You can't pass this without it. That's because this is something that the community overwhelmingly does not want. That the owners and businesses pay for their own security.
Thank you. My name is Rich Rydesdale. I've been a Venice resident for about 25 years, and I oppose it very strongly. And the sort of dystopian sort of picture that a lot of appropriate people present, you know, it's very hyperbolic, it's not really good. I own a house right off of the boardwalk, and you know, I don't find any of that stuff to be true. Very safe. And I just think that it will disproportionately affect homeless people. I just think it's not good that you guys are going to change the law.
Great, thank you.
My name is Liza Kapersky, and I'm the leasing specialist at Prolock Webster of Venice, who own the property of the proposed VIP district. We strongly oppose the bid. I agree that the boardwalk needs attention to address the issues of cleanliness and homelessness, but the BID is not the way to do this. Added security is not the way to address homelessness. Buildings in Zone 2, especially those that are residential and office buildings, will not benefit from banners, extra trash pickup, lights, and security should not be the ones to have to subsidize those on the boardwalk in Zone 1. Also, at least 25% of the properties in the BID are the city's property. So likely, the city vote will be the deciding factor that we believe is improper and outrageous. For a small group of property owners to be handed $1 million a year with no oversight is astonishing. Me and those at Co-op Webster are strongly opposed to it.
Thank you. Yes, you are.
Thank you very kindly, Dr. Whiteley. And I appreciate the opportunity to speak. Realize that it's actually a privilege that may be taken away from us, so we actually appreciate you this opportunity to speak before you. Our first human right is very important, because when we lose our first human right, we're going to lose our second human right. When we lose our second human right, we're going to get dictatorship. It's like Thomas that we talked about. Okay. I'm here because I think I like the idea. I know that some people might be against it, or you can make some of the restrictions and some of the alterations that they have suggested. I'd be in favor. Also, I'd be in favor about that first amendment right, so we can display our sign, our being able to communicate our first amendment rights, like baby lives matter. We have big things on the baby lives matter. Not all like that, but all COVID, after 6 months, maybe from the portion of restrictions, it's murder. Go on YouTube, watch it.
They term abortion is murder. Don't be fooled. It's murder.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
All right, there it is, Dill. Sir, if you're going to discuss the meeting, we're going to ask you to leave. Elizabeth Stinson. Marlene. Okima. Rachel. Roger Jones. And John.
Thank you, Councilman. I am a working artist, 46 years in Venice. The property I own is not commercial. There's no business activity, no stores, restaurants, hotels, and there's never been any businesses on it or commercial activity of any kind. We're put into Zone 1, which is the most expensive part of this bid, which makes no sense for Eastern Pacific properties. And we're also subject to what is being called the corner penalty, where we pay twice as much as other properties. This is some kind of blanket sweeping method of getting more assessment for the bid, and that's why these residents are being included. We don't have tourists in our area, we don't have litter, we don't have trash, we don't have encampments, we take care of our property. We don't need special cleaning, and we don't want to or agree with a private police force. We don't want ambassadors, marketing efforts, or promotion. We want to work, we want to be left alone. That's it.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, council members. My name is Elizabeth Hitchin. I oppose inclusion in the Venice bid. I am an artist and I have a studio on Venice Place. As a merchant, I have no commercial or industrial businesses on my property. I already maintain my property to a high standard. I do not need crowd control or ambassadorial services, transit info, or tourism help. I will be paying a huge assessment fee for business services that mostly benefit the tourism and businesses on Venice Boardwalk, a business assessment that will go up 5% each year. This is a big financial burden on me. Therefore, I'm requesting to be excluded from this Venice bill. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good afternoon. I'm a little nervous. I'm an artist in residence in a property that we've owned for over 35 years in Venice. We changed our zoning to artist in residence, and we love being an artist in residence. We feel that this bid is unlawful and misguided. The Venice bid was created from an absolute and obsolete zoning ordinance established nearly 100 years ago. This is a faulty and misguided system for classifying properties in 2016. The determination for inclusion in this bid should be for modern-day usage, not outdated zoning ordinances. Proposition 218 states, a business improvement district X assesses the properties in the district in proportion to the benefits people will receive, as well as to ensure the benefits to those parcels receiving are true special benefits and not general benefits the locality as a whole will receive. This bid exclusively benefits the Venice Boardwalk.
I'm sorry, can I get your name again?
Marlene Okulik.
Got it.
Two more things. Okay.
We can't. Okay, it's limited in time. I'm sorry, ma'am. Otherwise, I have to open up to everybody again. And so I can't do that. So thank you. Ma'am, I can't. Thanks. Ma'am, now you're disrupting the meeting. Sergeant, can you please ask you to have a seat? We're going to have to respond to you. It's not okay to be live. You're disrupting the meeting. That's your final warning. Thank you. Got to be fair and equal to everybody across the board on this. Thank you.
John Woodward, that lady's wife, her husband. And I am opposed to this business improvement district, which is really based originally for the Venice Boardwalk. All of these people, all the proponents of this bid are mostly on the boardwalk. And I am about a quarter of a mile inland from the boardwalk. I have no business connections. My building is a commercial and residential. I'm being taxed. 50% of my property taxes is going to go 50% for 50% of the benefits, so-called benefits. Tara DeVine is lobbyist. It's working in tandem with the city. has refused to answer questions, although Mr. Bond, I did have a meeting with him, he's been pretty good. We would like to be excluded from this. The equivalent of a 50% increase is
Hello, my name is Mary Ann Dill. I oppose the formation of this business district. I believe it was created for and by and for the boardwalk, and really has nothing to do with East Pacific Properties. We are also on a street that has no business activity, it never has. We don't have any hotels, no restaurants, no stores, no merchant activity. We understand the boardwalk wants this, but they have just drafted properties into it to increase the revenue because there's no benefit that we would receive. Also, we're in Zone 1, which is crazy, being two blocks east of Pacific, which is really not the same problems we have here. Also, I don't believe the wind addresses the real problems of Venice. My name is Rachel Jones, and for the last 28 years, we've owned a 5-year-apartment building at 14 and 11 in space, which is owned commercial, but it is and always has been an apartment building. We've been assessed $3,762 by Better Bid, plus an additional 5% compounding every year after 5 years. And that's a huge amount considering we're not in business. We'd be subsidizing those that will affordable merchants. We are also in rent control, subject to a different set of rules that pertain to housing providers. We are unable to maximize, of course, our building's full potential. We will look out a bit. But today I did hear from Councillor Vernon's office, Debbie Diana Harris, so thank you very much for letting us know that. Whoops!
Thank you very much. All right, next speaker, Jeffrey Harris, followed by Alan Roger Jones, Leo Renee, Judy Branson, Sylvia Shane, Roseanne Bofa, Mike Hill.
Good afternoon, Council. My name is Jeff Harris, and I manage property on the boardwalk. I've been doing so since for 12 years, and I've seen some unique challenges that the boardwalk has. Like the other speaker said, at nighttime it's very sketchy. So much so, we hire private security. And what I found is our private security was able to meet with the community, meet with the Pacific Division, and as long as you have a synergy between the private security and the Pacific Division, you shouldn't have a problem with, you know, out of control private security. It's desperately needed. Venice is the second most frequented place in the state. Can do much better with all of the people that are down there. It's a soft target. We do need deterrence. We need eyeballs on the beach. We need video cameras, and we need things after if a crime occurs. We had a recent crime and there was no witnesses. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Hi, I'm Judy Rapman. I've been in Venice 24 years, and I encourage you to oppose the bid. I come from four generations who lived in or slept on the beach, all tenants in Venice, and no one has ever been accosted. And the same for me, I'm a really late night person. I walk down, use my car down Main, Rose, Hampton, by peacefully sleeping people. And I'm probably the worst offender waking them up. I've never, ever had a problem. And I wanted to say, it's come to my attention that excessive force problems and bids around the city have forced the city attorney to send letters to the VIDs telling them that all security patrols will need to be registered with the LA Police Commission. So I think something has been going on that maybe you're not looking at or possibly aware of yet, but there are problems with VIPs, and I think it's really ironic that you have HHH on the ballot, but you are finding backdoor ways of criminalizing the homeless.
Thank you.
Sylvie Shane, I strongly oppose the bid. This is a misappropriation of public money to serve private interests. This is money that belongs to all of us. Bids have a storied history in marginalizing the poor through the use of private policing, and this is not the right way to go about it. I hope that anyone on this council who considers him or herself a progressive will recognize that this is just a way to take from the 99% to serve the 1%. Thank you.
Yosemite and see the gap. And this is what they're trying to make of the gap. I get on my way every night and I write peer to peer. I've been living in Venice for 30 years and no one has ever been approaching me. I've never felt unsafe. So I don't understand why we're turning into a business district and dragging people and whatnot. But you know what happens? Comes a business district and then all the business takes over and we change the face of Venice. I have a petition with almost 700 people in Venice, property owners that don't want it. And one last thing I have to say, who opposes it? Please, every single week we talk about somewhere else, definitely.
Thank you.
Hey guys. My name is Mike Hill, born and raised in Venice. My family owned the property there long before I was born. I oppose the bid. There are problems that are unique to Venice, but the bid is definitely not the answer to any of those problems. In 2016, the suggestion of a private security force is just unethical and unconscionable. It doesn't serve the people, and what this is really going to benefit is rich white people, and that's it. We all understand that. Thank you.
Good afternoon, City Council members. My name is Alan Roderick Jones. My wife was just stopped by the bill, so I'd like to finish for her. She received early this morning, an email from Daily Diner from Paris. I quote from that, and she says, "From what I understand, your property would still be in the boundaries, but not able to be assessed if it was zoned residential." So obviously we have to follow through and try and get our property zoned residential. We've had this property for 28 years, and it's an apartment block for five apartments. So it may cost us, but we're willing to go ahead. Thank you.
Thank you.
Dear Mayor Garcetti and council members, you must vote no on Council File 160749 because I have outlined in my letter to you today, you are illegally using California Street Highways Code 36600 sequential to evade the city's duties and people's rights under law. The intent of SHC 36600 is for businesses that are economically disadvantaged, are underutilized, and that are unable to attract customers. City of Venice doesn't have the light, and it's not economically disadvantaged. And so why don't you just collect the fees that you're not collecting? Why not collect the taxes you're not collecting? Why do you allow a whole group of people to just not have to pay into the fund? Because if you collected it, then maybe you'd have enough money to put in trash cans or replace sewers or all the other things you need. Call out my name on TV. Thank you.
Thank you very much. All right, that concludes all the speakers on this item. And so with that, make this fun.
Yeah, Mr. President, I just want to be
extra careful on this one, given the problems with the last public hearing. Is there anybody here who filled out a card or tried to speak on this and has not been heard yet?
Mr. President, you actually spoke through the council already at your maximum 3 minutes for the council rules.
No.
So thank you very much.
That's not true.
Yes, it was.
This is a public hearing, sir.
Okay. You spoke on all, Mr. President. Come on up for your 1 minute.
Thank you, sir. It's Eric Kerwin from CD2. We have a bid. In Chatsworth, you had a bid. I talked about it last week. Sometimes bids make sense, but in Venice, it makes absolutely no sense. And this one I looked at closely the first time it came to this council. It was exclusionary. The tallying up of votes was appalling. It smells to high heaven, quite frankly. And you've heard from many, many residents from the area who are residents, sir. The city has problems with finances and so on. So I have an idea for you. Okay, Google decided recently to cancel the fiber optic program. You want to keep the bathrooms open. Let's have Google make a donation and put the bathrooms on a 24-hour. They'll cover the cost. I can assure you, they'd be happy to. After burning rubber in this city, after telling the people of Los Angeles that they were going to put this big, and now they just quietly say goodbye to Ted Ross, we're moving forward. It didn't quite work out the way they wanted to. I honestly feel that the city council ought to oppose this bid. The people have spoken, too many people have been pushed this way and that. It's not appropriate. This is a special cultural landmark in Los Angeles. Don't screw it up. It's not going to work. Thank you. No, thank you. I'm sorry. Thank you very much. All right, so there's no other cards. Was there anybody else that filled out? I believe we had one. Mr. Walsh was also out of time, but I don't see him. Okay, so with that, no other speakers on this item. Mr. Mark.
Thank you, Mr. President. Thank you, colleagues, for your attention and patience on this matter. I want to thank everybody who came down here today to testify on both sides of this issue. You know, often it's the case that issues in Venice are contentious 50-50. This is certainly no exception. We've heard a lot of very strong and held opinion on both sides of this issue. And a few folks have asked, you know, why would you be doing this? One of the things that is a tremendous benefit of having a business improvement district in Venice is it brings additional resources and investment into the public area to help us keep the area, the beach, and the neighborhoods near the beach, all the way over to east of Main Street, safer and cleaner.
Fair taxation, please.
The number one issue that I hear about from folks in Venice universally is safety, is cleanliness. When I visit the St. Joseph Center and serve meals, I talk to people who are homeless who say that they feel sometimes unsafe in Venice and wish things were safer.
Fair taxation.
And cleaner. This is a way to help address that by bringing in money that we wouldn't otherwise have. I would say I acknowledge that there have been issues and problems with bids in other areas. But there have also been bids that have been very successful and have been great partners in solving homelessness. In Pacific Palisades, we have a bid that has actually worked with the Pacific Palisades Task Force on Homelessness and has helped get people housed. In Westchester, also in my district, the Westchester Town Center has helped hire people assisting the homeless path and help people get off the streets there. And it has been very useful and very helpful. I would say some folks have said this is not the way to solve homelessness. I think you're absolutely right. This is not meant to solve homelessness. This is meant to help promote the area. This is meant to help clean the area. And this is meant to help provide more security for the area. There are many, many things we need to do to help solve homelessness in Venice. I have enumerated 18 of them. You're all very aware of them. Some of you support them, some of you oppose them. But they're all very well known. That's how we solve homelessness in Venice.
Fair taxation.
I would say that my hope on this, because as I said, there have been good bids and there have been bad bids, is that this bid work to help on the issue of homelessness. I would like to see this bid work with the C3 that Sheila Kuehl just announced a few weeks ago. I would like to see this bid work with the HOPE teams, which are now functioning in Venice, to help get people into housing. And having the extra security at the beach, is an opportunity then to keep the bathrooms open, because we will have additional eyes and ears and security down there. I would just say one final thing to those who talked about the fact that they have properties that are zoned commercial but are used as residential. As I said, when I met with a few folks recently, I am happy to help those folks get their properties rezoned as residential properties, and I'm happy to meet with those folks and would even be willing to initiate a zone change from my end to make it a little less expensive and more helpful. I know a lot of folks have bought into properties that have been used residential but have been zoned commercial for a long time, and that's something we can certainly work on next time. So I want to thank everybody who came down here today on this issue. That'll conclude the public hearing, and then the balance will be tabulated this afternoon and announced and certified by the council tomorrow. So thank you. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you very much. Okay, so colleagues, there's actually, there won't be a vote on that, but I do want to let the public know that the public hearing is closed, and the ballots will be tabulated after.